Well, hey everybody, it's Dr. Jazz. Thank you so very much for joining me for the Finally Me For Real, the final video of this four-part journey we have been on. We started off with the making of me, the meaning of me, the messy me, and I hope each one of those videos of testimony, my shame, my transparency, has encouraged you and inspired you to know that wherever you are, it is not your destiny, it is just your itinerary. Well, this last part has to do with the miracle me. You know, when I look over my life, like many of us and many of you, and you look at the things you've been through the loss of my mom, through the death of a marriage, the death of my mom, not knowing who my dad was, being raped and molested, being born in a poor country, grew up in a poor village. All I can say is, I know I'm a miracle. I don't know about anybody else. I know I'm a miracle. And sometimes we think miracles is just, we think so small about miracles. For example, we think a miracle is when God heals somebody of a sickness or God raises somebody from the dead. But every morning when I wake up, I know I'm a miracle. I know where I am today. It's only by the grace of God that I'm here. And where you are today is only by the grace of God. So I tell people I'm a walking, talking, breathing miracle. In spite of all the stuff I've been through, in spite of all the stuff you've been through, hey, you are still here. Now listen, I read a quote this morning that is so powerful. It's by Mark Twain. It says, there's only two important days in the life of every person. The day they were born, and the day they discover who they are. And I don't know about anybody, but when somebody asks me, who am I? I say I'm a walking, talking, breathing miracle. And the only way you can know your miracle is you have to take the time and look at the past and look at the stuff that you came out of and the stuff that God brought you out of. And I know. I mean, if you ask anybody who ever been to Trinidad, and some of you guys have been to Trinidad, just ask anybody. Say, are you from Trinidad? They say, yes. And then the second question is, what part of Trinidad are you from? If they say San Fernando, nobody's going to raise their eyebrow. If they say San Juan, nobody's going to raise their eyebrow. If they say, oh, I'm from Tobago, that's the sister island of Trinidad, nobody's going to raise their eyebrow. But when you mention the word Laventille, they're going to be, are you for real? You from Laventille? Yeah, because Laventille is a drug-infested place that so many young people are being killed every day. And if they're not killed, they are being raped and molested. And that's why my sister's dream and passion was to get us out of that village. Now, we didn't know that when we were growing up. We were just trying to survive and make it in. When we realized what Laventille is, in fact, just Google it. And I remember living in Laventille, and I didn't see anything beautiful in Laventille. People were being killed, women were being abused, mistreated, being raped and molested, and God brought us out. Now, you guys have heard me when I shared my story with Bishop Jakes on TBN, that I had given the pretty part of the story on TBN when he said, oh, you got her? I said, yes, sir, I got her. And I thought the miracle was just in getting out. But the real miracle is not only did I get out, but I went back in. Every year I go back to Trinidad, and I don't go to the pretty places. I go right back to Laventille. I distribute book bags, I pray for people, and I minister for them. Why? Because I want them to see what a living, breathing miracle is. That doesn't mean I'm perfect. That doesn't mean I don't have any faults or flaws. We all do. But what it means is when I look back over my life, I'm not supposed to be alive in my right mind. I'm not supposed to be where I am. And so I want you to celebrate. in spite of where you are, don't forget that you are a miracle. For real, for real. Well, I hope you'll join me October 10th through the 13th. I'm going to help you discover and answer this question, who am I? If you haven't figured it out yet, if there's nothing that has surfaced, who am I apart from the title? Who am I apart from the prestige? You got to make sure you register for our Finally Me For Real conference. I hate to tell you, all the VIP slots are already gone. We got a few more in regular. Register today on finallymeforreal.com. And remember, the making of me, the meaning of me, the messy me, the miracle me, are all pieces that makes me finally me. I'll see you in October. God bless.